Cuban government cracking down on civil rights activists protesting the communist regime, stepping up police presence across the entire country. Crowds in Miami have taken to the streets in solidarity with the Cuban protesters as President Canal accuses the U.S. of causing food shortages and provoking unrest on the island. Florida Congresswoman Maria Salazar is a daughter of Cuban refugees and was just at a roundtable with Governor Ron DeSantis, and she joins us now. Congresswoman Salazar, first of all, you know I've been a fan of yours for years, so I want to say I'm thrilled that you won the job. And for those who aren't familiar with the background and your parents, just because I want everyone to understand just what this means to you, how your family came to settle in Florida in the first place.
Oh, well, thank you. And it's delightful to be delighted to be on your show again. Well, I'm first-generation American. You see, we came to the United States, the only country that received my parents, and that was 60 years ago. And that same country is the one that has to respond to this cry that the Cuban government, that the Cuban people are shouting on the streets of Havana. You see, it's key for everyone to understand that the United States is the one that can save the Cuban people. Why? With three things that we need to do. The Biden administration needs to do this right now. And I'm saying it, a Republican congresswoman representing the city of Miami, the heart of the Cuban exile community. There are no political parties, Republicans and Democrats. We need to unite as Americans defending the Cuban people that are shouting on the street at the word freedom, libertad. And why am I saying that the United States is the key? Because we are the ones that we cannot negotiate with the regime. We need to send a clear message to the military and to the repressive apparatus that they cannot shoot against the Cuban people on the streets shouting freedom. And they need to provide internet. Charles, it's extremely important that the Wi-Fi will not be shut down by the regime. Why? Because that's what they're doing. The hotspots and the internet access is very compromised at this hour. And why are they doing that? Because if they shut down internet, they can do anything to those people. They can massacre the Cuban people on the streets, and no one will see it. And that's exactly what they want to do. They want to say that this is they're rioting because of COVID and because they want vaccines and they want more medicine and they want food and because the American embargo has done this to Cuba. The only people that have destroyed that jubilant and jovial population into a almost the walking dead are the Castro brothers and its people, including Canal. So I cannot explain to you what a magnificent, difficult, and extraordinary moment we're living right now, because the Cuban regime is the one who has started every single democratic socialist revolution in the Americas. So it's a new dawn, but it depends on the White House, what's going to happen next.
So I'm pretty sure then you're certainly not happy with what we initially saw out of the White House, and they kind of jumped on this whole COVID excuse as well. What exactly are you asking or would you urge them to do? And by the way, are you happy with the way the media has covered this? Because they also feel like they're reading from the communist Cuban dictator, you know, the sheet that they gave him. Hey, this is what happened. And I feel like this is the opportunity for us to help our Cuban brothers and sisters who just want the kind of freedom. They're waving American flags over there.
Well, that's exactly. And where is Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and Ilhan Omar and the progressives on the floor, my fellow congressmen and congresswomen, those people that are shouting that they want equality in the United States, that they want diversity? Well, that's the same thing that the Cubans are shouting on the streets of Havana. So we need Bernie Sanders to say to the Cuban regime, yeah, the Cubans deserve the same freedoms that are being claimed by the progressives in the United States. But I don't hear their voices, because that is what socialism brings. And libertad, that's the word. So everyone has to be extremely solidary. There has to be created a solidarity at the international level being led by the United States. You asked me what is the Biden administration needs to do. You see, I'm welcoming the Biden administration. I don't want to say anything negative because it depends on the White House to put an end to this situation.
Congresswoman Salazar, I feel your passion. I understand. And believe me, America, this is an opportunity, and I do hope we rise to it. Thank you so much, and it was great seeing
you. Correct. That's correct. Wonderful to see you, Charles.